bottom. This is Dance Africa.
Hello, and thank you for joining CACE International. I'm Fakisha Kumbo. On this edition, we're at Brooklyn Academy of Music, talking with none other but the great Chuck Davis, who's the founder of Dance Africa. Welcome to the show, Chuck.
All right, thank you, and I'm glad that you have invited me into the community, and I give due honor and praise to the all-merciful Creator. I give due honor and praise to the ancestors, and I give thanks and greetings to all of the members of the audience, your viewers, who naturally have tuned in because they know you're the best.
Thank you so much. What is Dance Africa, and how would you describe it?
In 1977, Dance Africa was born. Now, Dance Africa was born out of the need to celebrate the fact that we had African Americans who had taken the time to research and study and carry on the traditions which were born on the continent of Africa. So the Chuck Davis Dance Company was scheduled to do a season here at the Brooklyn Academy of Music. Instead of only the Chuck Davis Dance Company, I asked permission to have a mini festival and invite some of the other dance companies to come in to showcase along with us. And Dance Africa was born. We had Nanadini Zulu, God rest his soul, he's passed. We had Charles Moore. We had the International African Dance Company. We had, Richard Barclay did the first artwork, and we had the Chuck Davis Dance Company. Yeah, those were the main units at that point.
What is the repertoire?
The repertoire for
dance, for the overview of Dance Africa?
The repertoire can stem from the research that that whatever the company is has chosen. There is a theme picked for Dance Africa. Each year's Dance Africa has its own theme. And the companies chosen to participate will select works from their repertoire to make this theme come alive.
How do you choose the companies that participate?
We try to use companies every other year, every 3 years, so that as many different companies can get showcased as possible. And we choose companies that have good track record. We choose companies that have popularity because we cannot get over the fact that the whole idea is to sell tickets and to come in. We want as many people to understand the history as possible. Companies involved in Dance Africa can go on to so many different things because they use it as a showcase. Because many times, because of time restraint, many companies never get a chance to perform for more than 25 minutes. So every company will put their best foot forward and choose the work from their repertoire which best fits the theme, but also best fits them as a unit.
What is your aim as director, and what is your mission?
The mission is to always present the highest quality of dance and music associated with the continent of Africa, and as is practiced and carried on here on these shores and throughout the diaspora, because we have used and will be, and even in the future, using companies that are not only from the States, but from Latin America, from Caribbean area, or wherever Africa is celebrated. But the idea is to always maintain the high quality and to make sure that the companies have something to say, that they aren't just someone on stage.
What is your role as griot?
As griot, in the beginning, we use it as narrator. Now it is still narrator, because in the sense of griot, then you're supposed to remember word for word and item for item that happened over the last 20 years. I don't have that ability. You know, I must rely on the caretakers and people who are recording the history. But for me, it's as griot is as narrator, as one who is pulling it together and making sure the history is told correctly.
Explain what libation is, when it is done, and why you do it.
Libation is where you pay homage to those who have passed on, but giving the first due honor to the all-merciful Creator. The libation is to make sure we remember and respect the supreme, the omnipotent force which guides our lives, as well as the ancestors and the role they have played.
How is dance a healer?
It's a healing because you become more involved in self, and as you become more involved in self, you become more involved in others as a group, and you realize that as an individual, you are part of the whole with something to say. So things that you think might be a problem turns out not to be so after all.
What is the role, if there is a role, of spiritualism in the dance?
Dance is spiritualism. It's not a role, it is the spirit, because we are not moving to move. We're moving because of an energy and impetus which stretches back since the dawn of time.
Are there socio-political elements within the message of the groups that you choose to dance in Dance Africa?
It's a possibility if the work showcase will have as its theme this, if the theme has to do with politics, or, you know, socio-political. For instance, a presentation of the isicathulo, which is the boot dance from South Africa, could be used in a way to address apartheid, the stamping out of it, the need to stamp it out. It depends on the choreographer, depends on the group.
In which cities will Dance Africa or does Dance Africa perform?
Dance Africa America is now presented in Brooklyn, Hartford, Minneapolis, Miami, Washington, D.C. And, of course, we're looking to add Atlanta, Dallas, and we have performed in Red Bank, New Jersey, Newark, and Los Angeles. But we're looking to add Atlanta, Dallas, and New Orleans.
What are the workshops and master classes about?
About presenting the traditional dances, the movements and cultures from the continent of Africa, and presenting them here as a part of Dance Africa in their original form by master teachers who have taken the time to go to Africa to learn from the elders.
Are there set months in which Dance Africa travels?
No, it depends on the sponsor. For instance, Memorial Day is set for for New York. Immediately following Dance Africa in New York is always Dance Africa in Washington, D.C. Sandwiched in between Dance Africa in Washington, D.C. and New York is Hartford, Connecticut. The week after Labor Day is Dance Africa in Minneapolis. Chicago, I didn't mention Chicago before, but Chicago always has Dance Africa in October. Miami will have it either in November or February.
So you may work year round with Dance Africa.
It has been to that point. And, you know, in trying to couple Dance Africa and maintain the African-American dance ensemble is really a bit much. But it's something that has to be done. And because, look at the nature, look at Chicago. In Chicago, we play Dance Africa three performances, and three performances over 1,400 people checks, you know, is there for Dance Africa presentation because it's at the Medina Temple. The Medina Temple seats 4,412 people, and it's standing room only and has been that way for the last 7 years.
Okay, speak about the African Bazaar.
When Dance Africa came into play, we wanted to give people who had never been to Africa a taste of the ambiance.